welcome to my Magicka Necromancer PvP build. As a race, I choose Imperial. I have all points in Magicka. My Mondus is the Atronach for more regen. And as a buff food, I use maximum health and Magicka. I can show you them. The buff food here, the melon baked parmesan pork. And as my potions, I'm using Magicka, Stamina, and Heroism. They are kind of expensive, but health regen in PvP is now kind of useless. You can still use Tri-Stat potion, because Heroism potions are actually kind of really expensive. As armor sets, I'm using Clever Alchemist on Backbow, Sword and Board, Sturdy Shield, and Defending Sword. I have a Restore Magicka Enchant on back bar, and on front bar I'm using Double Dot Poisons. So Sword and Board from Clever, Heavy Chest and Sturdy, Heavy Legs and Impen, and Medium Shoulders Impen. Then I have One Piece Barlog, also in Heavy Impen with Tri-Stat Enchant. Here I on the big ones I have Tri-Stat, on all the other small ones it's Max Magicka. Then I have 3x spell power cure, 2x impen, 1 well fitted, and 2 jewelry of spell power in infused, 1 Magicka regen and spell damage in infused, and the Malakut ring also in infused spell damage. And on front bar I'm using the Master Inferno stuff in Sharpened, and as I said with the Double Dot Poison. In general you can reach close to 6k spell damage with all those procs goes off, like if you proc Spell Power Cure and Clever Alchemist with the Master Inferno. So your Blast Bones in general will hit pretty hard, and also your heals are strong. Spell Power Cure actually procs pretty reliable with the skills we have. Since we have the both bars, we use our tether, which is also the AoE tether, so we can proc major courage on our group members. Intensive Mender doesn't proc it, because it doesn't count as your own healing, but still tether and resistance flash away are more than enough. So resistance flash, so a burst heal, and also to help group members out of trouble. Race Against Time is our snare removal, and to get overall speed on our class. Braided Tether is a nice healing over time, and it helps you to get really high uptime of spell power cure also on your group members. Intensive Mender, even though it has quite a short duration, the heal you get is just insane. Like, it heals you for 5, 6, even 8k every 2 seconds, and it's basically kind of the same tooltip. It's that the difference not super big, and you just get it every 2 seconds for kind of free. Armor buff, Summoner's Armor, and Ravenous Goliath at our defense ult. We can also use Spell Wall for a cheaper defensive ult. It's completely up to you what you actually prefer. On front bar we have Elemental Weapon as the spammable, Stalking Blast Bones, Flame Clench as a stun, and also to proc the spell damage from Master's Inferno. Degen for what's called Major Sorcery, and Elemental Drain for Mana Magicka Seal and the Breach. We have quite a few offensive ults to choose from. Like, none of them are really good. Like, Colossus is good for group, sure. If you are like solo, maybe go for Dawnbreaker. It also can get pretty high tooltip. You can try Soul Assault, like fully buffed ahead, 120k tooltip, which is a lot, and can hit decent. And you can also try using Animal Blast Bones. It's more like a dual thing, and if you time it correctly, your enemy will get hit by 4 Blast Bones into a stun, and that can be quite deadly, but the cost of 300 ultimate is just not, it's kinda high, let's say. Champion point wise, I choose every passive that is combat related, of course, and the active ones are Biting Aura for the AoE damage and Mastered Arms, and for the tankiness, the 10% AoE damage reduction and single target reduction. For our red tree, I choose Survival Instincts. Make sure to only put 10 points in here, otherwise you will nerf your own CP too much. Everything else, just get the passives maxed out. Then I have Juggernaut, when I'm CC immune, 10% damage reduction. Ironclad for more armor, and the more regen. So, like, fully buffed up with the regen, we sit at about 2k. Maximum magic at 32k, health 32.5, it's decent, and close to 17k stamina. Also, our stamina regen with the ghost up is close to 1.2k, so more than enough to sustain 17k stem pool. So yeah, that's basically it. Of course, I can show you the green CP. It's not really much combat related things except maybe Breakfall. As I have more duration on buff food, 10% chance to not consume a potion when I take it, more movement speed out of combat, and more mount speed. That's kind of nice if you take such expensive potions like Heroism. So yeah, enjoy!